graph is showing us that even though we have less macrophages, the few macrophages we have still are positive for CD31. So these are suggesting us that macrophages express an endothelial markers and they can be participating in the antigen. So I wanted to check also in the tumors if we have this marker. This is pretty new. Macrophages, they have F480 marker, endothelial cells, CD31. But if you look in the literature, macrophages positive for an endothelial marker, no, there is not much okay expression of that. So we were like wondering what's, you know, what's going on with this. So I checked in the marker if these macrophages were positive, and yes, they were positive for CD31. So I moved to the tumor to check what happened with the macrophages in the tumor. And surprisingly, also macrophages in the tumor are positive for CD31. Not all of them, but an important percentage. So macrophages are positive in the tumor and in the matrigen, and they can have endothelial antigenic roles. So we wanted to check this result by doing a PCR for CD31. So this is the 3B11 endothelial cells I use as a positive control. And two kind of bone marrow macrophages, and you can see a higher expression of the CD31. So these are positive for CD31 macrophages, and this again suggests the macrophages have an antigenic function. So going more into mechanism, we were wondering what kind of molecules macrophages can be using to increase antigenesis. So in this paper, and this work by Florin did, she did a gene expression array in the tumor-associated macrophages. And she did for different proteins that are supposed to participate in antigenesis. And those that are red, or more red, are with the high levels, are found in high levels in these tumor-associated macrophages. And you can see that one of them is the VEGF. We already know that macrophages produce VEGF. However, we don't know what this VEGF or macrophages is doing. So for that, we did a crossbreeding between two kind of animals we have in the lab. One is the VEGF flux, and the other one is the CSF1 receptor. It doesn't matter, a crossbreeding between these two makes animals that don't produce, that they have macrophages that don't produce VEGF. Okay? So basically, these animals have macrophages, but the macrophages cannot produce VEGF. Okay? So I inject the plaque to check if we have an infiltration of these macrophages in the plaque, but they don't have VEGF, what happens with the VEGF? So again, the picture of the plaques there, you can see that in the presence of basic FGF, which is our androgenic factor, there is a formation of blood vessels, which correlate with the hemoglobin content, and this is significant in comparison with the control. However, in the absence of VEGF in macrophages, even though they are in the presence of basic FGF, they cannot form blood vessels in the blood, and this is correlating with the hemoglobin content in the blood. So you see, like, a VEGF in macrophages is important, and these macrophages are doing angiogenesis. So now I want to check the infiltration of cells in this blood. So I inject the blood in the animal, and I took the blood out. I cut it again, as I said before, and then I check the infiltration of cells in the blood. So you see here in the control is, of course, no basic FGF, very few cells. In the basic FGF, but in the wild type, you have an infiltration of cells. However, in the animals that don't have VEGF in the macrophages, but have basic FGF in the blood, they have lower levels of cells infiltrating in the vaginae. And this is shown also by the graph. This is a significant difference. So in the absence of VEGF, or macrophages derived VEGF, there is less cells infiltrating in the plaque and less angiogenesis, as I showed before. So now, recapitulating all of this, I have a couple of things more to show, but to give the conclusion here. So the macrophages are essential players in the formation of the blood vessels, and also the expression of CD31, but macrophages could help as a tool for the identification and isolation of specific angiogenic macrophages. The migration of macrophages into MAGF in response to basic FGF suggests that this factor could be an important chemoattractive factor for the recruitment of macrophages in the tumor. And finally, VEGF signaling for part of the mechanisms involved in angiogenesis and tumor progression. So, just a final message, identifying the molecular basis for macrophages action will allow novel therapeutics to target this component of the tumor microenvironment. And my acknowledgement.